فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So inshallah ta'ala, what does Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah define Iman as? Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah believe أن الإيمان اعتقاد بالقلب. Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah believe that Iman is اعتقاد بالقلب, a belief in the heart. A belief in the heart. وقول باللسان and statement on the tongue. وعمل بالجوارح and actions on the limb. أهل السنة والجماعة, this is what they believe. ولذلك الإمام أحمد رحمه الله, what did he say? الإمام أحمد, he said الإيمان قول وعمل يزيد وينقص. That Iman is speech and its actions. It increases and it decreases. الإمام أبو عثمان إسماعيل الصابوني, in his Aqidah book, Aqidah to Salaf, وأصحاب الحديث, he said, ومن مذهب أهل الحديث, from the methodology of أهل الحديث, meaning أهل السنة والجماعة. أهل الحديث here is a synonym of أهل السنة والجماعة. أن الإيمان, that the إيمان is what? قول وعمل ومعرفة. That إيمان is what? قول, speech, وعمل, actions, ومعرفة, and it is knowing. يزيد بالطاعة, it increases with obedience, وينقص بالمعصية, and it also decreases with sinning. This definition that I just gave is the statement of سلف الصالح, the statement of the pious predecessors, من الصحابة والتابعين ومن صار على طريقه من العلماء المحققين لمذهب السلف. This is the path of the Sahabas, the path of the Tabi'een, and anyone who has treaded on their path. Rather, ijma'at and consensus have been brought that this is the view of Ahlul Sunnah. That this is their belief, it's ijma'at, there's no dispute about it. ولذلك الإمام الشافعي said, as Abu Qasim Hibatullahi Al-Lalaka'i mentions in his kitab, شرح أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة, he mentions in the fifth volume, page 886 to 887, that he said, وَكَانَ الْإِجْمَاعُ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ وَالتَّابِعِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ مِمَّنْ أَدْرَكْنَا أَنَّ الْإِيمَانَ قَوْلٌ وَعَمَلٌ وَنِيَّةٌ لَا يُجْزِي وَاحِدٌ مِنَ الثَّلَاثَةِ عَنِ الْآخَرِينَ. That Shafi'i rahimahullah, here he said, وَكَانَ الْإِجْمَاعُ, the consensus was, and this is Ahlul Sunnah's consensus, and it is their consensus. من الصحابة, from the companions. والتابعين, and from the تابعين, meaning the students of the companions. من بعدهم, after them. ممن أدركنا, that which we have met. So Shafi'i is saying, this is the belief of the Sahabas. This is the belief of the what? This is the belief of the companions, and it is also the belief of the students of the companions. And Shafi'i said, and those who we have met. Those who we met from the Aimat al-Sunnah. أَنَّ الْإِيمَانَ قَوْلٌ وَعَمَلٌ وَنِيَّةٌ. That the Iman is قول, عمل. قول mean here means speech. عمل here means action. وَنِيَّةٌ here means what? It means intention. لَا يُجْزِي وَاحِدٌ مِنَ الثَّلَاثَةِ عَنِ الْآخَرِينَ. That one does not... Yujzi here means jaza, from the other. Meaning one cannot replace the other. Al-Imam al-Bukhari said, لَقِيْتُ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ أَلْفِ رَجُلٍ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ أَهْلِ الْحِجَازِ وَمَكَّةَ وَالْمَدِينَةِ وَالْكُوفَةِ وَالْبَصْرَةِ وَوَاسِطِ وَبَغْدَادِ وَالشَّامِ وَمِصْرَ لَقِيْتُهُمْ كَرَّاتٍ قَرْنًا بَعْدَ قَرْنٍ ثم قرنا بعد قرن فما رأيت واحدا منهم يختلف في هذه الأشياء أن الدين قول وعمل. بخاري said, رحمه الله أبو قاسم هبة الله اللالكائي, brings in his kitab اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة, the first volume, page 173 to 174, that Bukhari said, I have met 1,000 men from the people of knowledge. I met them. I met the scholars, the people of knowledge from Hijaz. I met the ones in Mecca. I met the ones in Medina. I met the ones in Kufa, the ones in Basra, the ones in Wasit, the ones in Baghdad. I met them in Sham. I met them in Misr, Egypt. I met them, not once. لَقِيْتُهُمْ كَرَّاتٍ multiple times. قَرْنًا بَعْدَ قَرْنٍ generation after generation. ثُمَّ قَرْنًا بَعْدَ قَرْنٍ and then generation. I met them that while. All of them believe. فَمَا رَأَيْتُ وَاحِدًا مِنْهُمْ يَخْتَلِفُ I have not found one of them differ in the concept of what? أَنَّ الدِّينَ قَوْلٌ وَعَمَلٌ That the religion is what? Speech and action. So this is a consensus, ijma' Ahlul Sunnah never differed upon. So according to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Iman is a component of what, brothers? It's a component of three things. Three powerful points. The first one is i'tiqadul qalbi, which is the what? The belief of the heart. Wa qawlul lisani, and the speech of the tongue. Wa amalul jawarihi, and the actions of the limb. وعن هذه الأجزاء ثلاثة these three which is اعتقاد القلب وقول اللسان وعمل الجوارح these three there are branches that stem from it the branches that come from each one Ibn al-Qayyim also says إن العبودية servitude منقسمة it is categorized and divided عَلَى الْقَلْبِ وَاللِّسَانِ وَالْجَوَارِحِ It's categorized into these three. The heart, the tongue, and the limbs. You see, وَعَلَى كُلِّ مِنْهَا عُبُودِيَّةٌ تَخُصُّ Each one has a servitude, a عُبُودِيَّة that is specific to it. Servitude is connected to all those three. Now that we've mentioned the definition And we've mentioned the meaning of Iman and the reality of Iman according to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And we mentioned that this is a what? What did we say this is? This is Jama'ah. Two scholars of Ahlul Sunnah did not differ upon this particular issue. Ijma'ah. Who is Naqirul Ijma'ah? Who transmitted the consent? Al-Imam al-Shafi'i and the second one is? Al-Imam al-Bukhari. They both transmitted a consent for us. So based on that statement and based on those statements of the Salaf, There are too much, they can't be counted. Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they believe أَنَّ الْإِيمَانَ يَتَبَعَضُ That the Iman is not one component. They believe that the Iman is what? يَتَبَعَضُ مَا مَعْنَى يَتَبَعَضُ That the Iman can be broken. Ahlul Sunnah believe that. In other words, what does that mean? It means some of your iman can go and some can be left. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe this. That the iman yatabaad, fayadhabu ba'adhu, some of your iman can go. So it means some of the branches of iman goes, but that doesn't mean that all of your iman is gone. Are you with me, brothers? ولذلك الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية says رحمه الله تعالى he says وأصلهم their foundation whose foundation is he talking about أي أهل السنة والجماعة أهل السنة والجماعة's foundation is meaning this is the fundamental dispute amongst أهل السنة والجماعة and all of the groups if you learn this you will be saved from what falling into any of the what? The deviated groups. And there are two groups, right? The first group are known as the Murji'ah. And the next group are called the Wa'idiyah. The Wa'idiyah are two groups, the Murji'ah, the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij. So the first ones are the Murji'ah, and the other ones are the Wa'idiyah, meaning the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij on one side. You won't fall into what they fell into. You'll be saved from it. Huh? That's if you learn this foundation of Ahlul Sunnah. What's this foundation, brothers? أن الإيمان يتبعض. ابن تيمية says وأصلهم أي أهل السنة والجماعة أن الإيمان يتبعض. The أصل that أهل السنة والجماعة are upon is that the إيمان يتبعض, is parts. فيذهب بعضه ويبقى بعضه. Some of it can go and some of it remains. And then he says كما في قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم, as is in the statement of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, يخرج من النار that a people will be taken out of the hellfire من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من إيمان. A people who there is in their heart a mustard seed of belief, إيمان. أهل السنة والجماعة believe that these people were put into the hellfire because some of the branches of إيمان was missing from them, but the other part was there. Are you with me, brothers? ولهذا مذهبهم. And because of that, Ahlus Sunnah's madhab is أن الإيمان يتفاضل ويتبعض. That the إيمان is of levels. My إيمان and the إيمان of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and the companions is not the same. And this is to show that the إيمان يتفاضل ويتبعض. And he goes, وهذا مذهب مالك والشافعي وأحمد وغيرهم. This is the madhab of these علماء, أئمة. Good. So what did we learn? We learned that iman is what? Qawlun wa amalun. That the iman is qawlan, amal. Some of the scholars, they say i'tiqad. But some only say qawlun wa amal. The ones who say it's qawlan amal, i'tiqad is in what? It's in both. It's in both. Huh? Because they believe there's qawlul qalb and there's qawlul, there's amalul qalb. There's qawlul qalb and there's amalul qalb. And the i'tiqad falls under amalul qalb. Okay? So it's just basically dividing it into more or just summarizing it into two. So those who said al-imanu qawlun wa amalun wa niyatun wa i'tiqadun, and those who said al-imanu qawlun wa amalun, they've brought everything together. Okay? They've brought it all together. So based on what we learned, the first point was al-imanu qawlun wa amal. We also learned, according to Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that the iman is what? يتبعض فيذهب بعضه ويبقى بعضه. Some of it goes and some of it remains. The third point that I want you guys to know is the branches of iman. Iman is not one branch. We know that, right? The branches of an iman is not one level. صح؟ هي متفاوتة. That the branches of an iman is of different levels. Those branches of iman is all mentioned in one hadith. The branches of an iman. And the branches of an iman, yeah, is three. That every iman, act of iman or speech of iman or belief of iman will fall under one of these three. The first one is a foundation. A foundation, it's an asal, that if this asal goes, then your iman totally goes. It's called asalul iman, the foundation of your iman. The second branch is called kamaluhu al-wajib. Kamaluhu al-wajib here means the obligatory branch of iman. The first one is the foundational branch of the iman. This one is what? The obligatory branch of iman. The third one is kamaluhu al-mustahab. It means the recommended, the voluntary branch of iman. And all three of them are found in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said al-imanu bid'un wa sittuna aw sab'una shu'bah, right? A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah. The highest of the branches is la ilaha illallah. This is what asr al-iman. That's the asr of iman. Wa adnaha imatatu al-adha 'an at-tariq. And the second one that the Prophet mentioned is what? Moving harm, imatatu al-adha 'an at-tariq. Moving harmful things from the path, from the road. This is what? It was the third type I mentioned. كماله المستحب, the voluntary. والحياء من الإيمان. أما والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. And that shyness is a branch of الإيمان. And this is what? Huh? This is wajib. Shyness is wajib. So we have the three branches there. Who categorized it? Alayhi salatu wasalam. So the iman according to Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, based on that hadith, is that it's three branches, three levels. What is it? Asal, that if this asal goes, you are no longer a believer and you leave the fold of Islam, you are a disbeliever. There's a branch that if you leave, you are a believer. But you're in a serious situation. The third one is voluntary. This does not cause, huh? This what? Does not cause you to leave the religion, nor does it cause, but it only makes you lose the completeness of al-Iman. Your Iman is not full, 100%. The voluntary makes your Iman 100%. Allah also categorized those three people in the Quran. ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Three levels, right? What are the three levels? ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. There's one who oppresses himself. This one is what? Huh? Is one who's come with what? This one has what? Aslul Iman is there. What's there for him? Aslul Iman is there for him. Because all three of them, Allah promised us He's going to take them to Jannah. So he's got Aslul Iman, but he's missing Kamalul Wajib is missing from him. Are you there? The second one is what? وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِد. مُقْتَصِد means what? The one who has come with Aslul Iman, كَمَالُهُ الْوَاجِبِ, but what's missing from him is كَمَالُهُ الْمُسْتَحَبِ. The voluntary is missing from him. And then the Prophet, the ayah told us, وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ, the one that's gone far, is the one who's come with all three. Aslul Iman is there for him. كَمَالُهُ الْوَاجِبِ is there for him. And كَمَالُهُ الْمُسْتَحَبِ is also there. He's سابق, he's high up the rank. So all of those three branches that I just mentioned here, you find them in the Quran and the Sunnah. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that. Are you there, brothers? Are we all together? Are we all together? This is where the real discussion starts now. So far what I'm saying, is it making sense to you, brothers? Yeah? No? Huh? Sah? Now, let me read a statement of Ibn al-Qayyim for you. Ibn al-Qayyim says, I brought evidence from the Kitab and the Sunnah. Ibn al-Qayyim has a kitab called Kitab al-Salah wa Hukmu Tarikuha. The book of Salah and the one who abandons the prayer. He says, وَهَذِهِ الشُّعَبُ مِنْهَا مَا يَزُولُ الْإِيمَانُ بِزَوَالِهَا كَشُعْبَةِ الشَّهَادَةِ وَمِنْهَا مَا لَا يَزُولُ بِزَوَالِهَا كَتَرْكِ إِمَاطَةِ الْأَذَى عَنِ الطَّرِيقِ وَبَيْنَهُمَا شُعَبٌ مُتَفَاوِتَةٌ تفاوتا عظيما منها ما يلحق بشعبة الشهادة ويكون إليها أقرب ومنها ما يلحق بشعبة إماطة الأذى ويكون إليها أقرب. Ibn al-Qayyim says, there are branches in Iman. Okay? These branches, he says, منها ما يزول الإيمان. From those branches, there are some branches that things that if you do, what happens? يزول الإيمان, your iman will remove and it will go. بزوالها, your whole iman goes. You're no longer a believer. كشعبة الشهادة, like the branch of shahada. What's this one? لأن أصل الإيمان. This is the أصل of your iman. What happens? You're no longer a believer. You're a what? A kafir. If a person leaves off النطق بالشهادتين, the utterance of the shahadatain, and he doesn't say it, is he a believer? He's not a believer. Okay? So if a person comes with something that a person can remove his shahadatain, good. وَمِنْهَا and from it is مَا لَا يَزُولُ بِزَوَالِهَا and there is also some branches that your iman will not fully go. كَتَرْكِ إِمَاطَةِ الْأَذَى like if a person leaves off removing harm from the street. صح? What happens here? If you see a harm on the street, a glass, cracked glass, and you walk by it, what have you just lost? That's a branch of iman. Well, what branch is missing here? The voluntary, kamaluhu mustahab. You're missing that. This is what Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah mentions. Ahlus sunnati wal jama'ah, they differ within themselves now. What is, they agreed that the iman, yatab'ad, that the iman is categorized into asal, kamaluhu al-wajib and kamaluhu al-mustahab. They agreed. They didn't differ within themselves. But they differed within themselves what is part of aslul iman and what isn't. Meaning, in other words, what can we take a person out of for leaving Islam? Are you there, brothers? Are we all together? They all unanimously agreed upon tarku shahadataini, the leaving of the shahada is kufr akbar. That's ijma' amongst them. They differed within themselves. Ahl-Sunnah, I'm talking about. Within themselves, they differed on the Salah. Is the Salah part of Aslul Iman? That if a person leaves, it becomes a kafir? Or should we add it to Kamaluhul Wajib? That's their discussion. Are we all together, brothers? Rather, Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah had even bigger difference on that. They even said the four pillars of Islam after Shahadatain, the four other pillars, Salah, Zakat, Sawm, and Hajj. Takfir of them has come from some of them. Such as who? Imam Ahmad. And Imam Ahmad would make takfir on a person if he left the fasting. He would make takfir of the person if they left Hajj and Zakat. This is called Al-Mabani' al-Arba'a. Are you there, brothers? Brothers, pay attention to this. Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, when it came to Asl al-Iman, what did they do takfir on? Leaving Salah. Even the Mabani al-Arba'ah, the four pillars of Islam, because the Shahadatayn, I'm taking it out. That's agreed upon. The other four pillars remaining, they differed within themselves if whether it should be added to Asl al-Iman. And this is a khilaf that it is within Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Are we all together? Yes or no? Does that make sense, brothers? Okay. I want this point to be very well understood. And I want you to understand this issue very well. Now that we've understood that there is a khilaf amongst Ahl al-Sunnah, this khilaf is a discussion we can have, whether if you leave the prayer you're a kafir or not. If a person has that opinion, can we say he's a khariji? La. The qawl min aqwali ahli sunnah in the issue of leaving prayer. Because ahli sunnah differed within themselves if they should add it to asl al-iman. Even if somebody adds zakat in there, or even they add hajj in there, or fasting in there, they still are not khawarij. Because this khilaf is between who? It's a weak opinion. We can say it's a weak opinion, but it doesn't take the person out of the fold of Ahlul Sunnah. But anybody who makes takfir of a person other than the Mabani al-Arba'ah, from those four pillars of Iman, is Islam. Anyone who makes takfir of a person for leaving it, this is not Madhab Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. And they've opposed Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Okay, they've opposed what? They've opposed Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah. That's important now. How many points did I mention so far? How many points did I mention? First one, we defined it, al-iman qawlun wa amal. We defined iman in terms of qawl and amal. What was the second thing that we did? We explained that the iman yatabaad, that the iman tabaad happens, yatafadal. We also mentioned the third point was what? That the shu'ab of the iman laysat ala darajatin wahida, that it's not of one level. Now we're going to move on to another point, which is madhab ahli sunnah. Ahli sunnah wal jama'ah believe jawazu al-istithna'i fihi. The ahli sunnah wal jama'ah believe that you can do an exception in iman. What does that mean? It means if a person was to say to you, if somebody asked you and said to you, amu'minun anta, are you a believer? You are allowed to say mu'minun insha'Allah, I am a believer insha'Allah. And the reason why the person would do that is to stay away from tazkiyah. The reason is because when you say ana mu'minun insha'Allah, you're not praising yourself by saying that you came with kamaluhul mustahab. Because when you say mu'min, it encompasses all. What does it encompass? It encompasses all. So when you say ana mu'minun insha'Allah, they may understand from you that you're saying my iman is what? Is complete. So the insha'Allah, is it referring to the asl of your iman or is it referring to the kamal of your iman? Kamalul mustahab. No, it's referring to the kamalul mustahab. That the fact that you're a Muslim, you believe that. If somebody asks you, are you a mu'min? Yes, I believe. That I believe here is asl iman. But the insha'Allah is what? Kamaluhu al-mustahab and the wajibat, that if you're doing it accordingly. Are you there, brothers? Does that make sense? ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية says وأما مذهب السلف أصحاب الحديث كابن مسعود وأصحابه والثوري وابن عيينة وأكثر علماء الكوفة ويحيى بن سعيد القطان فيما يرويه عن علماء البصرة وأحمد بن حنبل وغيره من أئمة أهل السنة فكانوا يستثنون في الإيمان وهذا متواتر عنهم لكن ليس في هؤلاء من قال أنا أستثني لأجل الموافاة وأن الإيمان هم اسم لما يوافي به العبد ربه بل صرح أئمة هؤلاء بأن الاستثناء إنما هو لأن الإيمان يتضمن فعل الواجبات فلا يشهدون لأنفسهم بذلك كما لا يشهدون لهم بالبر والتقوى. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, he says, in summary what I just mentioned, that this belief is the madhab ahl sunnati, the madhab ahl hadith, like Ibn Mas'ud and his students, Al-Thawri, Ibn Uyayna, the majority of the ulama of Kufa, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan believe this as well. Ahmed believed this. And other than him in ulama ahl sunnah, they all believe this. They used to do istithna in iman. وهذا متواتر عنه. This has reached a level of multitude narration. But the insha'Allah here is not regarding asrul iman, like the murji'ah trying to make it look. Are you there, brothers? They mean regarding the kamal of the iman. Now we've understood the mu'taqad of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah in iman. And we also touched on some things that come out of the meaning and the understanding of iman according to Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, right? Now let's speak about the deviated groups that have come out. The deviated groups that have come out that have opposed Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah in this. We'll take a 15 minutes break inshaAllah ta'ala and we'll come back after that.